Okay, welcome to Cyber Security Lab. We already done first assignments part A. So today we will discuss about rail fence, row and column transformation. Then we will also discuss second assignment, implement the deep element key exchange mechanism using HTML and JavaScript. Before that we will get intro about some cyber security. So let's start with some intro. And I will show some program, okay, not complete program. So first okay, some theory about cyber security related. Okay, so the word cryptography has come from a Greek word which means secret writing, and there are messages, okay, and messages are sent through an unreliable medium is known as plain text, and which is encrypted before sending over the medium. Again, the encrypted message is known as ciphertext, which is received at the other end of the medium and decrypted to get back the original plain text message. So this process is all process is called as cryptography process, okay, and it is very essential for today's communication purpose. Okay, so again the cryptography algorithm is divided into two broad categories: first symmetric key cryptography and second public key cryptography. Okay, so we will simply see here. You can see in picture a simple cryptography model, plain text encryption, then medium, okay, there is a ciphertext which is encrypted, okay, and then decrypted again, and receiving end there is again plain text. Okay, then here is the symmetric key cryptography, so I will not discuss all this here. Okay, just you can see the picture again, the simple key cryptography model. So here is a key shared, same key shared, okay, and already we have seen in Caesar cipher. Okay, so there is a shared key for both encryption and decryption. Using that key, the message is encrypted and decrypted as per the requirement. Okay, again the monolithic substitution, here some plain text have some added encryption, and key is same for both. Okay, so already we have used this Caesar cipher. Okay, so this is the idea of Caesar cipher. You can see in picture here, there is a plain text, then there is a key is equal to 3, and then it encryption and decryption again, and then there are ciphertext related to that plain text. Again, polyphabetic substitution, here this is the improvement over the Caesar cipher, so we will not discuss here again it. Okay, then transpositional cipher, so this is our rail fence related technique. Okay, in transpositional cipher the character remains unchanged but their positions are changed to create the ciphertext. So we will see here. Okay, in diagram you can see there are some place changes, okay, positions are changes according to the cipher. Okay, so sorry for disturbance. Okay, so some positions are changed, so we will see in rail fence this transpositional cipher. Okay, so there are lots of cipher related theories here, we will not see all this. Okay, so this is a simple theory related to cryptography, and we will study more and more whenever we required for our assignment. Okay, so we will close this now. Rail fence, so transposition techniques, so all the techniques examines related to cipher text symbols have same technique. Okay, they use the same techniques, but in case of transposition technique, a very different kind of mapping is achieved by performing some sort of permutations on the plain text letters. Okay, so here you can first, okay, rail fence is simplest of such cipher in which the plain text is written down as a sequence of diagonals, and then read off as a sequence of rows. Okay, so there is a plain text, and the plain text is meet at the school house. So here the in cipher this message with rail fence at left 2. So these positions are changed. Okay, from the plain text the position of characters are changed. Okay, and this makes some this type of equis encrypted message. Okay, so here you can say meet. Okay, start M E E T A at. Okay, the T H E the, then S C H double O O L H school. Okay, then house for H O U S E. So this is a zigzag type of cipher. You can see here. Okay, so rail fence is very easy. So I will show you a program, but not complete. Okay, you have to complete that program. So we will go to our program. Gedit. .cpp. Okay, so sorry, I think it is not this. Okay, now I have write to gedit rail fence .cpp. Okay, this. Okay, this is the program. Okay, so some more theory, okay, if available. So I will show you. Okay, here. So rail fence row and column transformation. So you can write a program in C++ as well as in Java. Okay, so here is algorithm. In the rail fence cipher, the plain text is written downwards and diagonally on successive rails of an imaginary fence, then moving up when we reach the bottom rail, and we will when we will reach the top rail, the message is written downwards again until the whole plain text is written out. This message is then read off in rows. Then third, write down the plain text message as a sequence of diagonals. Then fourth, last one, read the plain text written in as step one as a sequence of rows. So here is another example. Original plain text message is come home tomorrow, and then again rearrange by using rail fence. So you can see come C O M E H O M E T O M O R R O W. So again the output is like here. Okay, so you have given some input, then it will be converted like this, and then there is a output related to that. So we will see in our program here. Okay, so I have opened it here. Okay, in C++, so you can see here. So I will run this program. Some error is here in program, so you have to remove this error. Okay, so I compile it. Okay, then I will go for running this program. Okay, now I type some words, okay, my name, then it will take like this. Okay, now here is the problem, because there is no compilation error, so I cannot understand where is the error. So it is like a logical error. So here some garbage value is reflected, you can see here, and actually we need to get here original plain text message. Okay, but here you can see the there is a original plain text message Prakash, then again it's encrypted using RailFence. Then we have to get this refresh. So this is your problem. You have to rewrite this program in Java or C++, and you have to get the original text from the plain encrypted message. Okay, so this is related to your assignment. Okay, so now RailFence is, I will not cover more about RailFence detail. So we will go to our next topic. Our next topic is related to second assignment, implement the diff-hellman key exchange mechanism using HTML and JavaScript. So you have to consider the end user as one of the parties, Alice, and the JavaScript application as the other party, Bob. So here I will provide some 1 minute. Okay, so we will get, okay, here. So we have to implement diff-hellman algorithm. So as I already told about, there are two types of cryptography techniques. So symmetric key cryptography, and second one is public key cryptography. So it is a elliptic curve cryptography, ECC in short, in an approach to public key cryptography, and based on the algebraic structure of the elliptic curves over finite fields. And ECC requires a smaller key as compared to non-ECC cryptography, and to provide equivalent security. So there is a 256-bit ECC security have an equivalent security attained by 3072-bit RSA cryptography. Okay, so it is equivalent to this RSA cryptography algorithm. Okay, so better. We will go to our elliptic curve cryptography understanding. So it is very important to understand the basic of elliptic curve. So there is a equation related to elliptic curves. Okay, it is a planar algebraic curve. Here you can see y square is equal to x3 plus ax plus b, where a is the coefficient of x and b is the constant of equation. Okay, so here is some theory related to this elliptic curves. Okay, so curve is a non-singular, and its graph has no curves or self-intersections. Okay, so you can see here in picture. Okay, then here elliptic curves could intersect almost 3 points when a straight line is drawn intersecting the curves. So here you can see a straight line intersecting these curves. Okay, so there are some six tuples here, P, A, B, G, and H, where P is field that curve is defined over, G is equal to generator point, A, comma B is equal to values define the curve, H here is cofactor, and N is equal to prime order of G. Okay, so we have equation here again, you can see, and P and Q you can see here. So y square is equal to x3 plus ax plus b. Now algorithm for diff-hellman. So it is used to establish a shared secret that can be used for secret communication while exchanging data over a public network using the elliptic curve to generate points and get the secret key using the parameters. So here we will consider only four variables, one prime P and G, okay, a primitive root for P, and two private values A and B. And again, the P and G are both publicly available numbers. Okay, and users like Alice or Bob picks private values A and B, and they generate a key and exchange it publicly. Okay, so here again the key is exchanged between sender or receiver. Okay, the opposite person receives the key and from that generates a secret key, after which they have the same secret key to encrypt. Okay, here is the algorithm steps. So there are public key available, P and G, for Alice and for both Bob, both have P and G. Then private key selected for Alice A, and for Bob it is B. then key is generated using that private key, x is equal to ga mod p. Again here in case of Bob, y is equal to gb mod p. Then exchange of generate key takes place. Okay, so key received is y and here key received is x. So again generate secret key as k is equal to y a mod p and here kb is equal to x b mod p. So algebraically ka is equal to kb. Okay, and users now have a symmetric secret key to encrypt. So they both have same symmetric secret key for encryption. Okay, so here is some steps also. So Alice and Bob get public key like p is equal to 23, g is equal to 9. Then Alice selected a private key a is equal to 4 and Bob selected a private key is equal to b is equal to 3. Again in step 3, Alice and Bob Bob computes public values. Okay, then x is equal to, here you can see mode related to the given input. Okay, so x is equal to 6 and again for Bob y is equal to 16. Then in fourth step, Alice and Bob exchanged both public key numbers. Okay, in step 5, Alice receives public key y is equal to 16 and Bob received x is equal to 6. Okay, then in step C, Alice and Bob compute symmetric keys. Okay, then Alice here ka again computed the mode mode for the given inputs. Okay, then is k is equal to 9, then for Bob kb is equal to 9. So you can see here both symmetric key is equal. Okay, so 9 and 9. So in step 7, 9 is the shared secret key. Okay, so we have to write relate program in Java or using HTML or in C++. So you can understand about this Diffie-Hellman algorithm. Okay, so I will show you the program here in C++. Okay, so here is some error. Okay, so I will show you it is related to some header files related, so I will correct it, but you have to again you have to practice it. Okay, so this is the problem for you. You have to rewrite in your C++ or either in Java or using HTML so you can get the proper output. Okay, so I will show you the code in C++. Okay, this one. Okay, here you can see the code related to this Diffie-Hellman key algorithm. So this is the here again we have taken some similar variables or input. Okay, p, g, x, a, y, b, k, b, k, a and k, b. Okay, so you can get this. So I will share this both codes to you with you and you have to practice it and rewrite the code again. Okay, so that's all about related to our both assignments. So here I will complete my session. Okay, and again we will discuss here this both assignment in virtual lab. So presently you have to write program in C++ or Java. Okay, for both these both assignments. So thank you, and session is over here.